Hey guys, Ivan here, and in today's video we got a couple of very interesting bodybuilding updates. I mean, the first one is not really an update, it's a photo that Samson posted, and it's basically at 6.5 weeks out of Mr. Olympia, but this is exactly the same photo he posted a couple of days ago, where he tagged his new coach and his, let's say, current coach, his wife. But what is interesting about this is that this photo does not have filters, or at least it's less heavily edited. I mean, I don't know, if I'm sure this one is also at least a little bit sharpened or something like that, but the other one was basically sharpened up to the max. So check it out. And it's very noticeable that this one is touched, but this was basically kind of like a poster promoting Merrick health and, you know, announcing that he has another coach now, so it's not like a physique update really, it's more of a poster, so I guess it was okay to edit it this much. And why am I even talking about it right now? It's because a lot of people were like, even how can you predict Samson winning based on this photo, it's Photoshop, this and that, but here is a new photo that is not as photoshopped, as filtered, as sharpened, as edited. The other one most certainly was sharpened up to the max, because when I tried to make a thumbnail, I tried to sharpen it up. Again, that's the times when you do these kind of things. When you're trying to promote something, like for a thumbnail or like for a poster, I'm pretty sure magazines used to heavily photoshop everything. I mean, they're still doing that. So when I tried to sharpen up the previous photo, it looked ridiculous, like it couldn't be sharpened anymore. But this one, it's definitely a lot less edited, but I think it's also edited a little bit. However, I feel like everybody is basically editing their photos at least a little bit. Come on. And so is Samson, and he was doing this basically always. Everybody's doing this. So when I compared this to last year, Samson Dauda at 7 weeks out, this is definitely a lot sharper. This is definitely much better conditioning. Even with the filters on, he's definitely in much, much better conditioning. And here is what he says, what he believes, where he's at right now. Let me show you.
Right now, I'm in the same shape as I was a week before we went out to, like, literally not even a week. Literally the day before we fly out to Ohio, I'm in the same shape now. And we still got 7 weeks to go. And I feel this good. So yeah, that's how much it's changed, you know. And 7 weeks to go, and I'm not even the point where I'm suffering enough to be here just like, oh, I'm miserable. So we got a lot of digging to go. So yeah, it has been a drastic change. But the fact that I feel this good, it makes a difference, man. Honestly, I can't stress enough. When you feel good and you feel confident and your mind is in a relaxed place and you're happy, your body takes on a life of its own to respond to everything. It's insane. It's insane, and that's what this prep has been about, and I honestly can't wait. It's gonna be awesome.
Alright, so Samson feels confident, he feels very good, not tired, at 7 weeks out, and he believes his conditioning right now is as good, not as good as 1 week out of the Arnold Classic, but 1 day out of the Arnold Classic. And here is a comparison, basically, from the Arnold Classic 1 week out, and right now. And is what he's saying true? I wouldn't say so. I think he was still a little bit sharper at 1 week out of the Arnold Classic. Like, you can see it in the chest. There was more separation going on. And also in legs. Especially, like, the legs did look a little bit drier. But it's not a big difference. I would say Samson, in 2 weeks from now, at 5 weeks out of the Mr. Olympia, at this pace, is going to be basically the way he was 1 week out of the Arnold, if everything keeps going well. But since he's not that tired, since he's feeling so fresh and so motivated and so confident, I mean, I think he can definitely keep going. I hope that in 2 weeks from now, we don't see basically the same thing we're seeing today. But I'm definitely seeing changes, like from 10, 11, 12 weeks out to now, like every week looks better. So it seems like he's on the right path, and he's very driven, he has a lot to prove, and again, this conditioning, it's not, I don't agree that it's basically the same as it was 1 week out of the Arnold Classic, like, it's not that good, but, you know, it's like probably the way he was 5 weeks out of the Arnold Classic, which is freaking insane, which is freaking amazing. If he can be a little bit sharper, like, let's say 20% better conditioned than he was, let's say, at the Arnold Classic UK, if he brings something like that, yeah, I have him winning. I believe he can do it. I mean, based on their previous performance, sure, Hadi's the favorite, but I am a believer. I believe Samson will pull it off this year. And there is another thing I wanted to address, and that's people saying that I can't change my prediction. I don't understand why is that. I mean, we are getting these physique updates for a reason, to see what these guys are looking like. And if somebody else starts looking better than Samson, I'm gonna have to change my prediction. What can I do? I mean, things change. You know, if Samson, I don't know, starts cheating every day until 2 weeks out, what am I supposed to stick with him for the win? No, of course I'm gonna change my prediction. That's the way I see it, it seems logical to me, but at this point, at 7 weeks out, 6.5 weeks out, I do have Samson winning that show. Whatever you guys think, tell me down below. Alright, next up, we got a new physique update from Hunter Labrada. It's 2 weeks out of Italy Pro, and yeah, his conditioning seems to be improving basically every week, and at this point, I mean, he is looking freaking massive. Like, really dense, really thick, and the conditioning came along. He's basically almost ready. I mean, there are only fine touches to be done in the last week or so. But yeah, that's pretty much it. He needs to cruise into the show, show up looking like this, and, you know, win his Mr. Olympic qualification. I don't think Nexila is gonna show up. I mean, he still didn't announce that he is withdrawing from the show. He's probably too embarrassed to do it because he pulled out of that many shows. It's crazy, but, you know, based on his last physique update, he didn't seem like he was gonna get ready for this show. And even if he does, he's not gonna be in this kind of condition. I don't see him beating Hunter Labrada, no. Look at Hunter's legs, man. Like, I feel like these legs can probably match, I mean, Exilas. Of course, they're not as big, but they have details. They're also very complete. They're just not super crazy, insanely massive like Nexila's, but they're big enough. Look at his legs, man. Very, very good legs. I mean, to this point, basically, Hunter was kind of known for not having any standout body parts. He was basically known as a complete, balanced bodybuilder. But at this point, I mean, I gotta say, his legs are a dominant body part, in my opinion. Like, those legs are freaking insane. And you can't even see the adductors here from this angle. His adductors are crazy thick. So Hunter is definitely bringing something special this year. He's gonna win that show, qualify for the Mr. Olympia, and then it's all about where in the top six can he place. Like, I'm pretty sure he's gonna be top six. I'm pretty sure he's beating Brandon Curry this year. But as far as Andrew Jack, Nick Walker, that's gonna be an interesting battle in my opinion. But we'll see in like 6 weeks, 6.5 weeks. This year's Olympia is gonna be really freaking exciting, man. Alright, we also have another very interesting thing. It's not really a physique update. I mean, you can see Derek's conditioning, basically the separation, the hardness in the shoulders and the arms, and it is looking very good. But the main thing about this is his lifting form. The way he is doing these T-bar rows, that started kind of a lot of talk, a lot of controversy on the Instagram, on the social media. And, I mean, what is there to be said? Can anybody really criticize his way of lifting? The guy has literally the best back in the world right now. And, I mean, we criticized Hadi last year, the way he was doing his T-bar rows. So let's compare this to Hadi. I mean, is it the same? Is it similar? I think it's a lot better form than what Hadi is doing. But it's not exactly textbook form, right? There's definitely a lot of momentum going on here, but Derek, with his back, he can basically do anything. It's the same thing like with Ronnie Coleman. He doesn't have to do any perfect reps. Even like this, he is definitely contracting that back, and only contracting the back, really. I mean, maybe the erectors as well, but like, it's not like his biceps are doing any of the work, or his traps. You know, in his case, with his back, with his genetics, with his mind-muscle connection, he can do this kind of stuff. Most people probably wouldn't do anything if they T-bar rode like this, but if you have a back like Derek Lunsford, all you need to do really is find something heavy, pull it up, let it go down, and pull it up again, and your back is gonna be working, basically, and it's gonna be contracted to the max. But if you're not Derek Lunsford, I wouldn't advise this kind of T-bar rows. Interestingly, Andrew Jack posted basically the same video, also T-bar rows, also 7 plates, and his form is definitely a lot better. This is basically, if you ask me, this is basically the perfect form. You know, his body is basically almost parallel to the ground, but it's basically the perfect angle if you ask me, and he's not squeezing at the top. I mean, this exercise is basically a power movement. It's all about the stretch in the bottom area. Even Nick Walker, the way he is doing T-bar rows is basically similar way. He is not squeezing at the top. And Nick is actually known for squeezing at the top of every single exercise. But here, look at what he's doing. Like, he's definitely focusing on the stretch part of the movement. You know, he's definitely having a lot more control than both Andrew and Derek. His tempo is obviously a lot better controlled as well. But in my opinion, what Andrew is doing is the best out of these three. So he's using a lot of weight, heavy weight, but he's also very, very strong. And his control is good enough. A little tiny bit of momentum, but not a lot. I think what he's doing is basically perfect. On that note, guys, if you're looking for a coach, not a personal trainer, but, you know, an online coach, a guru or a mentor, whatever you want to call it, you can hire me. I work with a lot of people that are trying to get in shape or ideally get ready for the stage. That's the process I enjoy the most, helping people get on stage. But if you want to just lose the weight or, you know, gain muscle, whatever, I can help you with that. Just DM me on Instagram. I'm definitely a lot more affordable than the other, like, top level coaches. But I can also provide great services to you guys, and I'm always there, I'm very available. So if you need something like that, DM me on Instagram once again. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Whatever your thoughts are about whichever part of this video, let me know down below in the comment section. If you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more bodybuilding content like this, subscribe to this channel. Thank you guys so much for watching, all the best, and bye-bye.